Welcome to my channel, Fat Dandelions. My name is Mildred Lee, and this is part 3 of the loaded pocket happy snail mail that I made. But I think I made it way too snug, so I cannot load it too much. So I'm gonna take this pocket out because I'm gonna show you later what I've put inside. So I have these two action, I think it's Project Life card, but I'm not sure, but it's about the card of a part of the world. I want to add this to, I'll do it like this. The reason I do not pull out the plastic bag because I want to put this postcard also that's about traveling. It says, do you come with me? So that's, as you can see, it's a postcard, and I love to find postcards when it's free, or I'll buy postcards when they are nice illustrated, and I will buy them. So these are, I found it, these were for free. I'm gonna put it in here. So now I can take the plastic bag out. Okay, so I have a little problem. Like I said, I've made it way too snug. So now I cannot fully load it like intended. But as you know, if you have seen my previous vlogs, I have sticker packs in here, a lot of cards, I mean postcards, pattern paper, what was the other, coloring sheets. So like I said, these I'm gonna put it aside. I found another bag, and I thought to myself, maybe just fold it in half like this and put it in here. I have a reason why I want to put it in there, just like this in the middle, because I couldn't find another card that could fit in there, because I have this die that I found next on my table. I've used a very thin paper. Let's see, what is that kind of paper? Cannot see what color it is. Well, as you can see, there's a little bit here, and I've tore it, because the reason I tore it, it is very thin paper, and when you do it in the die cutting machine, it sticks so hard on the metal die that it ripped a little, well, on two places here. So as you can see, this is ripped, and there it's ripped, but on the top part, it's not cut very carefully. So now I'm gonna cut the little piece that is supposed to, let's see if I can, wait. Put it a little bit to the left so I have a bit space for my scissors to cut like this. Chip. You see, that's the part that should have been cut. So now, as you can see, this part is loose. It's too bad, but I haven't tried to use thicker paper to run it through. So I'm gonna do that later. So this is an example that I wanna give. This is just one of the examples that I want, a die cut that I wanna put. So that is the first bag with the stamps, second bag with the die cuts, but for now just one. But later, after filming, I'm gonna add more, because I wanna try with the thicker paper if it will succeed. Okay, there's a point I'm gonna explain. In the beginning, when I did not have the experience of buying die cuts, I thought by myself, oh, the die cut, the picture on AliExpress, it's so beautiful, so fun, and it's in the theme that I love, that I want to have. And it came very, well, that was pre or before COVID-19 time. When did I buy this? 2017, 2016? 2015? I don't know. It's just a couple of years ago. I bought this. And like I said, it came very quickly at my address, at my house. And I run it to the die cutting machine. And I always test it with thin paper. And the first time it was beautiful, beautiful. Second time it stuck onto the metal dies, the sides, these things, these lines. And the third time, that is the one that I've showed you, it broke only on two places. But I still haven't done it, even though I bought it like 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago. I haven't tried it on the thicker paper. So I'm gonna do it, like I said, after filming. So I wanna do that. But while you run it to the die cutting machine, you have to, okay, pay attention now. You have to painstakingly, I have a toothpick, every hole, you know, touch through the hole to take all these small pieces of paper out. So sometimes when you run to the die cutting machine successfully, you don't have that problem. Well, you have to prick with a toothpick all the holes through. Because you have also these little holes, they exist because when you run with your toothpick through the hole, let's see if I find a pointy one, the piece of paper will lift off, so you can grab it and very carefully take it out of the die, out of the metal die. So these small, this one, and that one are the holes to make you run a toothpick through the bag so the paper will lift off on different sides of the metal die. So it's not just one hole you will get and then you have to be on your own. You are left to be on your own. That's not like this. So a good metal die has all these specific small holes, round holes, to lift in different kind of places of the metal die, to lift the paper off of the metal dies. So that's the reason. But I'm not talking about the small round holes. I'm talking about the numerous holes here that you have to poke through with your toothpick. Well, on AliExpress or any other hobby shop or online shop, you can buy special sticks, very small point, and you can go even more through this round hole. So now I'm using a toothpick. You can do, we call it in Dutch, saté prikker. So when you have these saté ayam, or how you say, barbecue skewers, you can use those to run it through. Well, these big holes, you can run it through with these. But I have this toothpick and it's very hard to go through the very small round hole. But I managed that. So, but like I said, for crafting, for every problem, it's not a problem in crafting, but for every problem, there's a solution. That means there is, in crafting, a material that you can buy to use that. So if you have metal dies, you have that special metal poking hole, poking stick to go through these very small round circles. So if you have, let's see, I can show you another one that's in front of me. Let's see, like this cat die, metal dies, like this, or this one. So the for example, this one is very easy when you run it to the die cutting machine. So as you can see, there are these round holes to, of course, lift the paper out of the metal die, because it's very, because pressing the metal die onto the plastic or acrylic plates, it's pressed very hard onto the metal die, the paper, I mean. So if it's like, it doesn't matter if it's a thin paper or a thick patterned paper, it's still stuck onto the metal die. That's why you need something to run through the hole, the rounder one. But then you have the others that makes the shape of your metal die. So like here, the eyebrows, the eyes, the nose, the mouth. These are there to, when you run this metal die through the die cutting machine, it makes the face of the cat. That's an example. So as you go like this, you have this part, and this part is easy to poke with the poker through the hole, and that will make the perfect result out of the die cutting machine. But if you have something like this, this is a nightmare, to be honest. And I didn't think about that before I buy it. So when you buy a die, metal dies, you have to carefully look good at the metal die before you buy it, because I didn't think about that before I bought it. And I was sitting here like 3 or 4 years ago, like, oh, I want to swear now, but I'm not gonna swear. I sat behind my desk and I had to poke each hole through so that the paper on the other side will come out. That was so painstaking. How do you say it? Action thing to do. So that's a thing. So, okay, let's continue. So, like I said, I have two bags. I want to make another bag. This one, The beautiful bags I keep, and the bags that are like ugly or dirty, I don't keep. So this one I kept, but there was this picture on the bag. And it gives the illusion that these stickers are in this bag. And I don't want to give the illusion. So I carefully take the piece of sticker out. Sometimes you can manage to take the backing off. And sometimes not. There is the time that is when it's stuck onto the plastic and you cannot take it beautifully out. Then what I always do is find the biggest sticker that I get. Like it was like this, you know. And when you've like taken all these sides out, you have the remnants of the ugly leftover sticker. Like I said, I put, I don't know. Let's say. This piece of vellum is a sticker. I find the biggest sticker that there is, and I stuck it onto it, so you don't see the the ugly part of that remnants of the sticker there. So now I'm gonna show you that I have these stickers like these. Wait, what can I do? I'm gonna cut it out like that. Chip. So I have four stickers here, and I'm gonna put it in here. These are stickers. Close it up, and then I have a third bag. Three baggies in total. Of course, I can add more stickers, but for now I haven't found any yet in my box. I have a box where I put. Gonna show you. Oh, if I can take it out, I have a box. Okay. I have a box. It's a shoe box. some kind of shoebox, but it's not a shoebox. And I put everything that is about traveling. So I thought, like, I'll put the name on it. I wrote Wanderlust. So here are there a lot of pattern papers, stickers, things, washi tapes that's about traveling. So I'm gonna put it back next to me, and then after filming I have to put it back on top of the shelves because I took it off the shelf. So let's see. I was not ready. I was not done filming. Correction. I was not done decorating this part. So I'm now gonna decorate it now. Let's see. Where's my double-sided tape? Check, check. Yeah. And now I've lost my double-sided tape. That's weird. Oh, I found it. Yeah, I have a messy table. I'm sorry. Not smart. Like I said, I'm trying little by little. Not cleaning, but it looks like cleaning because it's so messy in here. I really can't find anything that I want, and that's very hard when you are decorating. So that's something that I try to avoid. This is a stamp, an actual real stamp, but it's already stamped on. It says already here, I don't know if you can see it, the date. So it's quite a long time ago. Someone gave it to me. So I'm really happy with these stamps. Let's see. Try and take the backing off. And then do it like this, stick it on like that. Okay, so I have something else, I think. Well, where was it? Oh yeah. So I have something. I always try some things that are combined. So I had a metal die of a plane, airplane. So I used that to funny day, I was just sitting here and die cut. Sorry. Wait a minute. Yeah, I'm sorry for that. So I had nothing to do. So I took everything. I'm gonna grab everything that I need here. Oh yeah. So I had nothing to do. So with the metal die I made with this kind of paper that I found in Action. It's so beautiful. And I die cut it all. So there you have it. So don't know where to put it. Where shall I put it? I think best is here. Okay. So I thought by myself, because I have so many papers like this, I cannot use the dark one because it's also dark. So I thought by myself, shall I do the green one and then put it on top like this? Or like that, a bit low, and then like here? Or just the airplane? I'm gonna just do the airplane. So now I'm gonna grab some double-sided tape. Oops, come on. And then put the airplane over. Let's see if I can find a beautiful spot. Like this. And then like that. So, there you have it. Try to get the backing off. Like this. So now you get the airplane. die cut, and I'm gonna put it over here. Let's see. Like this. Okay? Okay. So, don't know. Let's see. There's this empty space in here. I want to put the donkey in there. So I told myself, maybe that's funny. Like this. Choop. Okay. So, this is the loaded pocket. Let's see. I have, oh yeah, oh yeah. So I have the stuff here. I want to add also, I found something on Flow. This page, and then you turn it, it says where are you good at, what have you done to be better at, whom did you learn a lot, and what did he or she learn teach you, and all these things that's in Dutch. So I thought to myself, shall I rip it, because these are I don't know if you can see it. These are rilled. We call it in Dutch rillen. I don't know how to say it in English, but they are already pre-cut. All you have to do is like rip it like this. Of course, I can cut it, or how do you say it? Yeah, cut it with scissors neatly, but I don't want to do that. So like I said, I'm now already in 21 minutes, and I'm rushing a bit, so. So I can crunch some time, and I have a lot of cards now. So I have, let's see, I want to put a card that is representing the whole lot. So like this. I'm gonna do it like this. Oh yes, this is perfect. A bag, because I only have like 4 beautiful stickers for it. So I'm gonna add these stickers also, stickers, cards in here. So wait. Oh. No. Wait, I'm gonna do it like this. Oh, wrong. Like this. Like this. So that 2 pieces here, I can cut it also. So it will be smaller. Oh. And then also put it in there. Like that. So you have the cards and stickers. The cards from the Flow. And the stickers, I put it just in one baggie, because I don't think I have... Yeah, it's so messy in here. I don't think I have more plastic bags for that. So, as you can see, those bags are quite thick now. And it won't fit in this pocket anymore, because I did it way too tight. So, now you have to put it like this. And I wanted to add... this is a coaster. Look. So it says here, a coaster. So when you have let's see, I'm gonna try to run it in my fingers, but it won't go. If maybe I can do it with an X-Acto knife. No, it with the scissors it's perfectly good. So this is a cork coaster. Oh wait, it's not completely open. So there are a few of them in the pack. So I'm gonna add the coaster also in here with not in here with those. And oh yeah, yeah. So I'm gonna put it aside. While I was uploading one of the vlogs, I took, I don't have a needle here, because my needle basket is somewhere else in this room. So I punched very carefully. You see this compass here? I punch it very carefully with a toothpick, as you can see, because actually there is this annoying thing of me, a very annoying thing of me, on my desk. It's so messy. I have these punches, and I cannot find the one with the 1 millimeter. So that's the reason why I had to use my toothpick to punch a hole in this, because I want to show you something. Because I couldn't do it with this one. This one has a rounded ball in there, so I couldn't punch the hole in it. So luckily, with force, I did with toothpick, but you have to be careful not to cut yourself. So I'm gonna have a box. Yeah, normally I think you put food in here, but in my case, I'm not gonna say what's in here. I'm gonna show you what's in here. So I have this. Can you see it? It's an enamel pin in the shape of a paper plane. So I thought to myself, I can add, I have to pinch this so it can easily come off. So I thought